So this one, you are there with your systems, right? Now everyone with Ubuntu only, because somebody reported that in Pentas unable to install. So are you people ready with your systems now? Because we have to do some installation. Anil Naik, are you with Ubuntu open now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you are ready then. Bhargav?
No, sir.
Can you open?
Actually, I am
Okay.
attending from home.
Okay. Janardhan, Janardhan?
Yes, sir.
You can open your system, right?
Yes, sir.
Kindly open. Everybody, please open your Ubuntu system, because we follow some installation part, and we'll do some experiments. Because last time what we have done is, just let me take you there. Last time, see, we experimented this one. Let me close this one. NGSpice also required. Whether you people have installed in your system NGSpice? You have to come in here.
No, sir.
Okay, so kindly this command, open your terminal, and this command, can you see sudo? Can you see this one? This portion, this portion. Are you able to see this one?
Yes,
Yes,
sir.
sir.
Kindly type this one, sudo apt hyphen get, sudo space apt hyphen get. Sudo space apt hyphen get space install.
So for CentOS also we can type that command.
CentOS, I am not telling now. CentOS, I had to cross-check once, because I did not test it on CentOS. CentOS commands are yum something different. They are not apt-get. That's why I am not telling on CentOS.
Okay, sir.
If you are there on CentOS, I will send possibly today night or tomorrow morning, I will send the commands. You can watch what is going on.
Okay, sir.
Others, those who are there on Ubuntu, kindly ensure that you are typing this sudo space apt hyphen get space install space, and then hyphen y, then space ngspice. On a screen, you see where I am hovering my mouse. You see the command. If it is done, you please tell me.
Done, sir.
After that, you kindly type ngSpice. Then you should see this sort of terminal. Once you type ngSpice, where I am hovering my mouse here, everyone should see this ngSpice space one, and then hyphen, and then greater than symbol.
Yes, sir. Coming.
Okay, what about the others? Let us go to others. What if no one trying, then also you kindly respond, I'm not trying, so that I can proceed and you can watch, and later time you can try. If you are trying, then tell me that I am trying, and then I will wait for you.
So drawing.
Okay, if you're trying, that's great. Let us poll how many are they trying. You kindly, okay, typing best, I think. At least trying, and Ganesh trying, and kindly type here in the message those who are trying. So a count will come, how many are trying, so like that. Okay, three guys are trying. Okay, others also encourage others. Kindly open your system and ensure that on the screen what I am showing here, these two you are trying. That is, first one is this, let me scroll up. Sudo space. These are for Ubuntu only, not for CentOS people. CentOS people, tonight or tomorrow, I will check every command and I will test myself first, and I will send the those commands to you people. But others, those who are there on the Ubuntu, ensure that sudo space apt hyphen get space install space hyphen y space ng spice that you are typing. It will take for some time. After that, a terminal will come again. In that terminal command prompt, you type ng spice. Then it will take to ng spice terminal, not to the Linux terminal, ng spice terminal. That ngspice terminal looks like on my screen where I am hovering my mouse here. I am just highlighting that sort of thing you will see. You should see this one. If you are seeing this one, ngspice has been successfully installed in your system. You should see on my screen this sort of terminal, ng spice space one space hyphen greater than symbol. If that is coming, you can unmute and you are done, you are ready. Finished. Sir, I am not trying because I have CentOS 8. No problem. CentOS people, I will send tonight or tomorrow morning. I will try myself. I will send. Padma Saranya trying. Okay. Janardhan trying. Shore also trying. Yatish trying, but he succeeded. Okay, that's great. Others, I think they are not having system or what. I don't know. But if you do hands on, then you will get. Experience of watching this. Okay, Anil Nayak also finished. Okay, that's great. Okay, once that is done, okay, I think okay, shall I proceed to the experiment? Because we have to do this flow. Theory is you can get in any book. What is floor planning, you type, what is placement, what is theory also I will take up, but my point is most on practical, sir. Yes. Okay guys, those who are still trying, kindly watch for a while, stop doing what I am going to discuss that you watch. You can stop because it's taking more time. You can stop that one. You can watch. Later, I am here to help you out. I'll be helping you in case if you have any technical problems. Okay. Let us proceed to the where we left last time. Kindly watch. And the moment when I am switching from this tab to that other tab, don't type anything because. I will not be knowing what you are typing. You kindly unmute and talk. Okay. So, and unmute and on WhatsApp message, on WhatsApp, you please drop a message in case if you are losing the connectivity. Okay. Let us go to the experiment. Experiment is last time kindly see this one. Last time we have done this one. Let me close everything because several things I was practicing. Last time, this FA folder we have created, if you remember. And in FA folder, we have actually opened this terminal like that. Through terminal, we did everything. And now, being in FA folder, what we did, Qflow space GUI space, this ampersand we type. Then we got this one. Having obtained this one, we talked about every this user setting, and we talked about just a moment. Is this visible? Is it seen by everyone?
Yeah,
yes, sir.
Okay. Then we talked about this synthesis setting here. This only synthesis setting is nothing. This synthesis setting itself we are doing in the preparation here. Preparation. We are selecting a technology file here and this top module file here. This top module, as said last time, if you have arithmetic logic unit, in arithmetic alone, if you have several sub module like multiplication and division, all that, if arithmetic top is your top module, that top module you have to select here, Verilog top module here, in this here. So after that, set stop, we talked about what is the point of set stop. So after that, every flow we have demonstrated. If you have any query, you can ask me. Okay, I will stop at this point if you have any query. So assuming that no queries here, I am moving to what is next. What is next is, if you go to this where you have created this layout folder, and source folder and synthesis folder. These three folders and including this log folder, these are created by the tool. This tool has created, where is the tool? This tool has created. We simply invoked the tool. This tool has created. But the best practice is to create a layout, source, synthesis, and in source folder, we have to keep all our source files here inside. Now, if you see that FA.v, there is an arrow pointing to a shortcut. This is a link. This link is actually pointing to this because I did not create when I invoked my tool here last time when I was demonstrating, you know, you people here. I simply created a make directory space FA, mkdir space FA. After that, I straight typed this one. So inside this FA, I actually created with the help of gedit, that is a text editor, any editor you can work with, but I prefer gedit, it is so, for me it is convenient. So this one I created, this file I created last. And I also created my test bench file, this test bench file. So in fact, what I am suggesting is, according to the people who made the tool, they say that you create in your working directory layout, source, synthesis, these three folders, and keep your source files in the source directory. Anyway, this one we have done, but though you are not creating, see what I am demonstrating is, though we did not create, but tool has created, and also the log file it has created. Inside the log file, every activity that we are doing here, that is synthesis, place, static timing analysis, routing, all these related logs are here in the log directory. Now the point is, if I go to the synthesis, you see here f_synth_rtl. This is, if you open this one, and if you scroll and if you see this everything here, these are the standard cells. You see, there is some OR2X2, NAND 2, this one, NAND 2X1. Are you seeing, are you able to see them, these gates?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these gates actually synthesize the software, this synthesis tool has generated. And the name of this synthesis tool is Viosys. So that this is this one attack here. That is this one, Y-O-S-Y-C. Yes, why? Yes. This is not EOSIS, YOSIS. They are saying YOSIS. The synthesizer. This tool has generated this file, a synthesized file. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to, if I want to synthesize, simulate standard delay format SDF, what I have to include this file, whether it is what this file is having, only this gates. From where this, at this moment, I will take this one. What we have is your verilog.v file. This .v file is your full adder. Your design is full adder, fp.v. The other file that you earlier had was test.v. Last time we simulated this one, we have demonstrated the results. This one is only performing functional simulation. Functional simulation. Because this is simply a Verilog code, and this is a test bench, and both are giving us a functional, no time involved in that. Timing is not there. Time means you have this gate and another gate. This gate itself may be having some delay, and this gate itself may be having some delay, D2. And this net also may be having net delay, N1. And this net also may be having some net delay. So these net delays are not taken, nor this gate delay taken into the consideration last time when we simulated using iVerilog simulator. Now what we have done, this synthesis, this Verilog file we have taken and given to a tool called Viosys. So in order to simulate this, synthesis this design file, apart from giving to this Verilog HDL code file, we also have to give library file, .lib file. By taking this FA, your functional description and library file, this tool will map the functionality to the required gates from the library. That, let us see that first, that library, where that library is and how it looks like. Let us see that one. This is your library file .lib file that you have taken. So this is Oklahoma State University. Those people, if you type this entire thing, if you type in the Google, then you will get that. So what you will get? You will get that who has developed this standard cell library. That information you will get. So if you see here, this file having every information like slew, threshold, and gate information is also different. So for example, if you take here cell and two inputs, one output, 2x1, maybe 3x1 also may be there, 3 inputs, 1 output. So for everything they have described here, pin A having rise capacitance this much, fall capacitance this much, direction is input. Similarly, if you see the output, direction, output. So the point here, why I'm telling you this one is, that's how the library file looks like. your library file looks like, and this file you binded with your design. You have chosen the synthesis preparation and wherein you are taking your verilog file, and the technology that you are binding is this particular technology you are binding it. So having taken this synthesizer, Viosys tool, it is mapping this functionality to some gates, and those gates are picked from this library. And that library is what looks like this way. So you can scroll, and in your own system, you can explore this one. Furthermore, we'll discuss later on about that, but we want to demonstrate something else here. So anyway, this is a library portion. Now, if you want to, let me go to this one. In the synthesis, if you focus here, one is FA underscore synth RTL, one is FA synth dot RTL BB dot B. The other is FA underscore synth RTL no power, no PWR. So every file you open and you explore, my point is here to tell you people that you kindly explore what is there inside. Netlist file. This is the netlist file. Earlier netlist file, this one is including your GND VDD. Them you have taken here as the input. In fact, you did not put in your Verilog HDL code there. Did you put in a Verilog HDL code ground and VDD? No. You have kept only ABC, sum, and carry out. But synthesizer has taken this. Why? The question I will answer later on. But you keep thinking that way. The background, backend tool, what is happening in the backend tool? What is that happening? So it has taken this one. Now let us explore to another netlist file. In this netlist file, you don't have that. The way you have described your A, B, C, they are sum and carry out. Them only you have here. Other than that, there is nothing. Other than that, this standard cell library is invoked here. That is mapped to this standard cell. So that is another observation that you have to make. Another observation if you make here, in this, you, this is additional thing. VDD is binded to 1 and the ground is binded to 0, if you observe. So these are the observations that you have to make, and you have to keep thinking why it is. If you don't have answers, I will answer later on. But the point here, what I'm trying to make is, a synthesizer tool has generated a netlist file. Most of the times we heard netlist file. What is netlist file? Means it is going to bind to this standard cell library from where this tool has picked them from this library. That library you people have seen now. So this library, what information it is having inside, that is another thing that I'm asking you to explore, so that in a better way you will understand in subsequent discussions. So kindly explore this one. Now let us move to the simulation of this. That is, we performed first this simulation, right? This is not having any standard cells. Simply functionality is there, simply functionality. And that functionality test we performed. So that is a functional simulation, no timing involved. So time involvement is there, means a time involvement means delay information involvement. Delay information again of two sorts, two types that has been discussed, net and delay, gate themselves. Net and this. And further, if you go, some parasitics are there. Parasitics from where they come, that is again different part to be discussed. But at this level, after synthesis, post synthesis simulation, if you want to perform, that will that be called like a timing simulation? Question. That is question. Can we call it a timing simulation? question. If yes, then why? If no, then why? But the point is, if we perform post-synthesis timing simulation, this post-synthesis result is mapped to standard cells. Standard cells. This standard cell library is not having information about the delays. Net delay information it is not having. Net delay information it is not having. It is having only gate delay information. But in a practical system, so every delay needs to be taken into the consideration. So let us see how we are going to perform the standard cells using this post-synthesis simulation. In order to do the post-synthesis simulation, what is required is post-synthesis netlist is required. Post-synthesis netlist is required, and your earlier test bench itself. Additionally, we need .vlib library format. Library in .v format. Anyone having any question about this? Is that clear for everyone? What I'm talking about? Let me clear one more time. I'm talking about pre-synthesis simulation, post-synthesis simulation. In pre-synthesis simulation, we have our dot V functional description of our design. And we have test bench. This functional description and test bench, these two, when we perform the simulation, it is a pre-synthesis simulation. We did not perform any synthesis. We are performing simulation. That is a functional simulation. No timing involved in that. It is a functional simulation. Now, after post-synthesis, this dot V is converted to what? Some netlist format. It is a netlist format. In this netlist, what we have now, standard cells are there. Some delay associated with this delay information is there in this netlist file. On what basis we are telling? On what basis we are telling that some information is there? Gate delay information is there by seeing that lib file dot lib library file that we have used for synthesis purpose. So that is SDF standard delay format simulation, SDF simulation. More practical timing simulation, this is not called more practical timing simulation. It is only part. Practical simulation includes, practical timing simulation includes net delay, gate delays, any parasitics, all such information if taken, and if you do the floor planning, that is after floor, we are showing here in this this synthesis report, we are talking about this synthesis file, synthesized file. This synthesized file, if you go here to your tool here, We are not talking about placement. We are not talking about static timing analysis. We are talking about at this stage, at synthesis level output. At synthesis level output only we are talking. But the moment when you go to the placement and the post route, this is static timing analysis. Meaning what? Where is that? Just a moment. Here, this entire thing is post synthesis. We did not go to the placement. In the placement, again, some delays definitely will be added. If you go to the routing, if you do the routing, then additional delays will come into the picture. More practical, meaning what? More practical. So this is, if you include this last one after routing, then that is perfect timing simulation. And that is perfect timing simulation. At this stage, we are not talking about after placement. That is also one timing simulation that we had to demonstrate. And we also had to demonstrate after routing the timing simulation. And now we are trying to understand the SDF standard delay format simulation, and wherein perfect timing will not come into the picture. And how do we simulate? These two things we are trying to explore today. If time permits, this open timer also we will study. Using open timer, how we see this slack, whether violated or not. So by taking some examples and how to run this using these commands, how to enter into that tool, that we'll see if time permits today. So is this clear, what I'm trying to present? Is this clear to you people here? First of all, pre-synthesis and post-synthesis. In pre-synthesis, we have .v file and test bench file. We are simulating, means no timing involved here, only functionality check is done. That is pre-synthesis simulation. After post-synthesis, we are obtaining a netlist. This netlist includes standard cells. These standard cells come from the .lib, and this .lib includes some gates, and those some gates include some delay. Earlier I have shown you them. So though they are not perfect, they themselves are not perfect timing point of view. Why? Because they are only talking about the gate delays. But a real chip will not talk about only gate delays. A real chip also will talk about this net delays and gate delays, and including the routing that is there, them also will take into the consideration. Overall, what is the performance after routing, we will come to know. That is different issue that we have to study at these different levels. Once placement is done, once routing is done, at every stage timing we have to study. That is different issue. Is this clear for you? And this simulation is called SDF, standard delay format simulation. And for doing the standard delay format simulation, we need a netlist file after synthesis, and we need .lib in .v format, and this test bench. These three things, if are there with us, then we can perform standard delay format simulation SDF. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we are going to see how we are going to do that one. What I'm going to do from here is, just a moment. I'm going to copy this one here somewhere. I copy this one. I create a folder FA2. In this FA2, I am going to take this file. I should take this one, because just a moment. From synthesis, this one I have to take, because this one, why I am taking, because everything is defined here, even VDD, ground, and what should be the value, that is defined here. That's why I am taking. Either you can take this one, or you also can take this one. This one, and you cannot take this one. This is also a netlist file which is having a standard cell library, but this is having additionally this. You have to handle this. You only have to handle this one. Since handling this one sometimes possible, sometimes may not be possible in the test bench. So that's why this sort of netlist we are avoiding, and we chose a netlist wherein only standard cell library components are there. Standard cell components are there. and our own description. We have described this only. A, B, C, some carry out. We did not describe entire this portion. If you see our Verilog HCL code, that is this one. Where is that? This is our Verilog HCL description. Simply assign, we did A plus B plus C, and we assigned this to carry out and sum. That's it. But if you see the netlist, that A plus B plus C is mapped to some gates. That is happened because of open source Viosys synthesizer tool, and it has mapped to this hardware. And this netlist we are taking now. This netlist. Let us copy this netlist and let us paste here in the folder that we have created. Here I'm pasting this one. Now what is required? I cannot simulate this one directly using the test bench. If I simulate directly using the test bench, what happens is simulator will say this is not defined. OR X2, NAND 2 X1, NAND 3 X1. All these gates not defined. Such error, simulator will throw. So for that reason, what I am going to do is, I have to take this one. You see this library. Library is a .lib format. But simulator will not understand .lib format. It will understand .v of the standard cells. This is a standard cells. So what I do is I locate where they are. You everyone remember this path, that standard cells .v format is here. I go to this other location I am going. That is the root location. Kindly note how I accessed means. I have gone to these files and then these other locations and then computer and there here user and there here I think local. In local share you have Qflow. In Qflow you have tech. In tech you have this Oklahoma State University, this folder. There I have this entire format, all format. This library, I picked actually this library, right? So of this library, .v format is this. Is that clear to everyone? Is that, hello?
Yes, sir.
So if you open, if you open this one, you can see all gates here, all gate definition, every gate definition is here with their delay. Every gate delay you see here is other gate delays. So all gate delays, you can keep scrolling down, all possible gates .v format. This dot lib is there, no? This dot lib we binded here. Where we binded? Here. This technology we are using actually, this Oklahoma 018, this is the technology file that we are using. This format is, if you see this format is, in something, this is a tool understandable format for synthesizer. For synthesizer, it is a tool understandable format, for synthesizer tool. But your simulator tool will not understand this format. This is a, of course, this is a design and two input, one output cell here. This, if you see the cell here, cell description here. But this sort of description is only for synthesizer tool input. For that, .lib is there, .lib format. And the format is this. You can open it at your home, you can go through that. But your simulator will not understand. The equivalent of this .lib is this .v. So the path is here. computer, user, local, share, Qflow, tech, in that this you will see. So I am copying that one. Copy and come here and paste it here. So done. Now only one thing is required, that is test bench. The test bench here already last session I have created for demonstrating Ivory law. So I take this one. I copy this one and I paste that one here. Now I am ready with every file here. Test bench file is there. My description is there, my full adder description. This is the synthesized netlist file. This is not my description. This is a netlist file. In this netlist file, this information, this standard cells information is there in this file. This .v file. So now I am ready with my every file now. I can invoke my tool here, that is open terminal here. Now you know how to invoke that tool. I very long space. What you do, you have to first compile. So let us compile. Let us see first the list here. The list is this. We have all these three. So let us compile them here. I very long space. Then FA underscore the synthesis. And that that one, and this FA test. So them I am compiling. So after compiling, if I do ls, then you see there is a dot o out. If you don't want to see a dot o out, last time we demonstrated. Here we have to give I verilog space hyphen o space the file name that you want to see, and then space all this that you want to compile. If you give them with that name, it will come. By default, if you don't give any file name, it will generate a dot out like that. Now we have to execute that one. For execution, vvp a the dot out. So that we have what we have done. We have executed. Now we have to invoke that waveform viewer, that is GTK wave, and then that output file. So what is the output file? If not remembering, you just do ls. Now you see this fa.vcd. So now you invoke that GTK wave fa.vcd. Now enter. Oh, there is GTK. I typed GTL. It is GTK. It is GTK. And then enter. So now you see the signals here. There are several here because the standard cells are there. They are also now seen. Earlier, last time, these are not seen there. So now we are interested in this one here. This FA signal. In the FA signals also, there are several. We have to locate where my signals are. A is my signal that I am dragging here. B, and then C, and then sum, and then carry on. So then you drag, and this full view or zoom fit. You do, you will see them here. Since this is a simple example, you will not see the much delay here. If you take complex examples, then you will see those delays. You take a complex design, for example, Boose multiplication algorithm, you will notice here A, B, C. After that, at some delay, this output can be seen after some delay. But now you are not seeing any delay. This is because of that standard delay format. In the standard delay format, as been said earlier, that is not going to include. If you see this gate, where is that? Your standard cells. This standard cells, these delays are almost negligible. These delays. This is a path delay. This is including a path delay. A to Y, B to Y, and these are the delays here already specified by the this library people. Are you noticing them? Are you noticing?
Sir.
These are the delays. These delays actually, what we call them, library characterization. This is a one field of job in the VLSI industry. People will do library characterization. This library characterization is done by running NGSpice type of simulators and noting down these delays, slew, delay, all that. Those people will note down for a given what we say gate. What is the delay that is coming? They will make a note of that, and some format will be given by the tool developers. And in that given format, they will put those delays. What is that delay coming if we use that particular technology? So this is what you people have to understand for today. Let us summarize. I think I cannot go to this, not possible to demonstrate today because most of you people, I think, not install this one, Open Timer. But we'll discuss a bit about Open Timer now. The point here is, the summary of this today's session is this, that this, where is that? In this, at this stage, at synthesis stage, two things are required. Those two things that are required here are .lib and .v file. These two are required for the synthesizer. That is the first takeaway. That is the first takeaway. .v file, that whatever the description that you write, .v or .vhd, no matter, any HDL, or .sv, the system very long, no matter. But the point is HDL, anything that is HDL. But since we are discussing very long, so .v file. Along with that, .lib file given by the foundry. These two files are required at this stage, at synthesis stage. And this synthesizer is an open source synthesizer, that is Viosys. Instead of this Qflow, Qflow is only helping to integrate all these tools. Synthesis, at this level, we are using Viosys. At placement, we are using Greywolf. At starting timing analysis, we are using STA, starting timing analyzer, STA, open STA, we are using open STA, is a tool name, open STA. The other tool is this one. We have to use separately that. This is not tied with this Qflow. Open Timer is not tied with the Qflow. We have to use separately that one. That I will demonstrate how separately we can use that Open Timer. Open Timer is a award-winning static timing analyzer. This link I will share. Otherwise, you also can type in the browser Open Timer. Then a story will open like on GitHub. Lot of story is there. Kindly read, take out time. So this is very, very competitor to the industry standard tools. From the Cadence, all that. So you can read all this contributors' acknowledgement, everything, and what awards they have achieved. Everything you can read that here. So who is using Open Timer? All that stuff is there. You can read. A lot of things are there. So, but the point what I'm trying to make here is in the Qflow it is not integrated. What is integrated then? Open STA is integrated. Open STA is not that caliber in a timing analysis. But for academic purposes to understand, we are using. And routing, we are using again, Qrouter is the tool name that we are using at a routing stage. And coming to the this NetGen we are using here, and the DRC we are using, that is the Magic Layout Editor, and this is the NetGen is used. The point here, what I'm trying to make today's session is this synthesis. since we are using this technology file, this technology file equivalent standard cells .v format also will be there, wherein all standard cells will be there, and this is understandable to the simulator. While you want to simulate post synthesis, only post synthesis, not post floor plan, post placement, not post routing, post synthesis only. In the post synthesis, these delays are not going to impact your design performance. These delays are only associated with the gates, and those gates are not going to really impact the performance. It is just like a functional simulation only. That is the takeaway for this today's session. How to simulate and how to see is you copy this standard cells .v format, and also take your synthesized netlist, not your functionally described one, synthesized one you take, and the test bench can be used the same earlier at the first at the very beginning what you have used. The test bench throughout till routing also you can use. So these three are required, and then you have to launch your iVerilog and you have to perform the simulation just to ensure that this gate delays are not going to impact your design performance. So that is today's discussion. And before wrapping here our discussion, I request everyone this anyway I will post in the WhatsApp group this link, but you have to follow these steps to install in your system. Kindly install, because we will work with few examples here. Installation they have given here. If you see build through CMake, so in your Ubuntu, since you have installed the Qflow already, CMake is there. That's why if you follow these steps, that is enough for you to ensure that this queue timer is open timer is installed in your system. So kindly do it today itself, this open timer installation. Go to this build through CMake and follow the steps given here. So that's it, your installation is done. And for testing purpose, that will be there in for example in my system. If I go here, in your system also this happens, because you are also going to do the same like what I have done. That's why it will be like here somewhere. Here open timer will be here in your system also, in your home folder. If you go to the this one, what we call this, open timer directory, there you will have this OT. So the path here, what they are telling us, that we have to follow this path. Go to bin and simply run OT shell. That path is I am showing here. In your system also the same it will be like. If you go to this open timer, and they are asking us to go to the bin, right? And the bin, and then you run OT shell. If you run OT shell, you should see in your system this sort of prompt here. OT and greater than equal to greater than sorry this prompt. If you are seeing this, you have successfully installed open timer in your system. Advantage of having this one is to perform static timing analysis. The other tool that we have in our system already existing, this static timing analysis tool is the Open STA tool. That Open STA tool is nowhere going to match with that Open Timer. It is required for your PhD work or your M.Tech work, Open Timer. So guys, with that, today's class we wrap. Hope you have learned something. Kindly try this one, what you have learned, going to all that folders and taking them on somewhere here, creating a folder and copying, pasting them and running a iVerilog. And meanwhile, I asked ngSpice also. ngSpice, why it is required, I will tell tomorrow. I forgot actually. So that is also required. I will tell why it is required tomorrow, I will tell. So with that said, if you have any queries, you can stay, or else you can sign off.